During the news, Frankie went out to meet Siya Kolisi.
I did.
I have gotten good news. Siya is still here.
Yes, he hasn't left. His words were, nice jersey.
Oh, yes. Huh? Oh, because you're wearing the Stormers one. Uh-huh. Really?
Yes.
Did he really say that or you lying to us?
No, he said, nice jersey. I was like,
you got a compliment from Siya Kolisi.
I know. I was like, yeah.
You're blushing, bro.
Yeah, I know.
Gosh, Frankie, did you buy that shirt yesterday?
No.
This is the away jersey from 2 years ago,
yeah,
Cindy.
I think it's 2 years, two, 3 years
he
ago.
He said it five times today. Mm. Come on.
Frankie, if you could have dinner with only one person, Taylor Swift or Siya Kolisi, who would it be?
Taylor Swift, obviously.
Okay. Well, obviously.
Really?
Yes.
Tay Tay. Look, I love Siya. But
he's not Taylor.
No. Are we going to have to physically restrain you?
No, not at all.
Sia's taking it personally.
Oh, he's taking it personally. No, sorry, sir. I meant Siya. Sorry.
There goes that.
He's a lot bigger.
Yes, he is. Yeah.
All right, after these, Siya Kolisi will be on the mic.
The 947 Breakfast Club.
Check it out.
The 947 Breakfast Club.
The 947 Breakfast Club.
We have one of Western Province and Springbok's favorite sons in studio this morning.
Siyamthanda Siya Kolisi.
Siyamthanda Kolisi.
There were goosebump moments when he led his country for the first time.
I was just excited just to be Springbok captain.
Osoko, Lucas 16, Kajun, Gonyaka, ka 1991.
He was named the man of the match the very first time he played for the Springboks.
What Tibana no tatu Eric Songwick? What you tatu Songwick? Quatini? Where now is Oxalum Poko?
Me coming from the township, not having a lot, your dreams start becoming much bigger because you have everything basically you need to be whatever you want to be.
The first black African captain of the Stormers.
My strongest way of leading is making sure that I do well on the field.
Siya Kolisi leads out his Springboks.
We've got Siya Kolisi.
And that's exactly who we have today. Siya Kolisi. Yay! Now, listen, Siya. When you hear those things, right? Because obviously you go to bed every now and then and, you know, you're drifting off into bed. When you hear those things being said about you and how proud people are of you, do you still find like it's too surreal for you and you feel like you're a fraud, like it's all going to end anytime now?
Yeah, 100%. It reminds me like of where I come from most of the time, you know, when you hear all that kind of stuff. But like, I get inspired at the same time, you know, and it reminds me that there's so much more to do. And I know somebody else's story is also going to be like that one day.
Because, you know, your story is, it's sad to begin off with, but I mean, it's got a happy ending.
Yeah.
But, you know, you hear people tell stories like, no, some nights we used to go hungry, we didn't have supper. Yeah. You're too big to go hungry, bro. Like,
but
like
I was
concerned.
I was small then. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah, so I only grew when I just started eating every single day, which when I went to gray.
Oh.
Yeah, because I was very small. I had a small head, big ears, big hands, and big feet. And then
everything's
grown into it.
I reckon people around him are still going hungry because of how much he probably eats now.
So tell us that story about going to Grey. Because, I mean, being we're talking about a Grey PE, Grey Bloom. Yeah. It's a big school to go to.
Yeah.
How does that happen?
So I was playing a rugby game against another township school. And we got 50 points. We lost. But then the coach came to me and he said, I see something special in you. So then I went to his school.
You went to the school that beat you by 50 points?
Yes.
Okay.
Then I went to his school. So it was also in the township. Then he organized my first provincial trials, played, and then I made the under 12 B team. And then the grade teacher wanted two of my schoolmates. But then my coach said, you have to take this one too.
Because
I wasn't good. I was small then. Oh. And then he kind of forced me until I forced them until they took me. And then, yeah.
So the other two, do we know who they are?
Yeah, it's Papam and Zolani. They didn't carry on with rugby after.
Oh, yeah. No ways.
I was actually
special
with them at our 10-year reunion at school.
All right.
Yeah.
So now tell us about this freedom of movement. Because I saw the advert and it's an ad that I've always wanted you to do, like telling your story, showing us that first game and all of that. And it's so special that you teamed up with Freedom of Movement to do that. Tell us about that.
Yeah. First of all, we met a while ago with the brothers, and we've became more like family. I call them brothers now. And they've always wanted to do something special in South Africa because they're young guys, same as me.
Mm.
And while we started working together, they started obviously learning about me and understanding what I'm passionate about. And there's nothing more I'm passionate about than giving back to where I come from or changing kids' lives in the township, because I want kids to have a little bit more than what I had, you know. And so they thought, what do I want to do the most? And I remembered when I first played rugby, and it was a field of gravel. And I thought, you know, that is not healthy compared to what I saw when I went to Grey. And I said, every single kid needs an opportunity, and this is the opportunity for us. And then we started making the shoe.
So the first time you played on grass, the first time, now, do you remember the day you first, because you're playing on gravel your entire time. And
Imagine tackling someone on gravel. Yeah.
You're none the wiser, right?
Well, so it's gravel and grass. Patches of grass. And some fields that we played in had, but it was a lot, like there were thorns and stuff, and we played barefoot, so... When I went to Grey, it felt like a carpet. It was beautiful.
That's how you got then. You were so good. You were like, oh.
And then when you went to Newlands, it must have felt like a Persian rug.
Best. It's still the best. My favorite field.
So, I mean, you say, what is it that you want to do? So you want us to buy shoes, and then you're going to do what?
Yeah, so with some of the profits, we're trying to raise money to actually resurface the field. There's a field in Bekwen in Paul. It's a youth center. It helps some of the schools in the township with the matric pass rate, so they have computers and everything, and they have a soccer field and a gym, and it's based in the township, and there's coaches and stuff for the kids. There's so they get help with homework and schoolwork, and they can train afterwards. And then the rugby field is the only thing that's not hasn't been fixed. So it's full of sand, as you can see.
Yeah,
you can see
on the video.
I felt strong about it because we obviously wanted to do it in my school, but I felt strong about it because there's a sense of education there and something for the kids to go back to straight after school instead of getting caught up in your other stuff.
I think it's even more special that you're not doing it for your school, because that's a given, right?
You know,
Siya went to that school, Siya Iskolo Sasezwide. But you are seeing a need for this place that is literally the backbone for kids in the township in Cape Town, and you want to bridge that gap. So this is why we firmly behind you, and I'm firmly wearing these shoes, by the way.
And they suit you and works out with your whole outfit today.
Thank you.
Let me just say, so Freedom of Movement, they've been making these incredible leather goods for a while. They make like bags and all sorts of things.
Great bags.
And obviously you've teamed up with them to make these shoes. It's all locally made as well.
Yes.
Proudly South African. And you dig that. It's the same with the Frankie stuff as well.
Yeah.
Locally made.
Yeah.
Where can we get them? So if people want to buy them.
Online, www.freedommovement.co.za. And we have 9 stores nationwide. Yeah. So we have one in Mall of Africa, Rosebank. And I'll be in Rosebank today just to say hello to a couple of people.
The entire world is going to go to... What time, Siya?
We're going from
which parking,
Siya? Between 10 and 11.
10 and 11 at Rosebank. Freedom of Movement. Yeah. All right.
And on the website, www.freedomofmovement.co.za, all the bags. And does it specifically say there, Siya shoe collection?
There is one website for it, but there's obviously a website as well for everything else. And it's amazing. I think everybody should go and check it out.
So how much do you need to fix this field?
It's 200K for the field. Obviously, if we do well, we're going to see what else we can do.
That's
afterwards.
Nice.
So it's not going to be... It's all about how this project goes, because we want to do so much more.
Yeah.
And the more the people get involved, and you know what? The feedback we've gotten from people on our social media and stuff, people are already buying it, and it's really inspiring. I mean, when you're wearing the shoe, we want you to feel that you're making a change in South Africa. There's a kid out there who's, you know, whose life is changed by you just buying the
shoes.
There's
a Siya Kolisi.
Yeah, 100%.
We're buying the shoes, and we are grooming the very next generation of Siya Kolisis, because 100%. Somebody did that for you, and now we must do it for somebody else.
Indeed.
That's amazing. I love that.
And the shoes are nice. I cannot stress how good looking the shoes are. We're going to post them on all our social media platforms. When we come back, Frankie's got a request for Siya.
I do.
Of course he does.
Of course I do.
The 947 Breakfast Club. The big interview. On the 947 Breakfast Club.
This is big.
Siya Kolisi in studio. He is the captain of the Springboks. He is the all-around nice guy and is quite a good fisherman as well.
He is, apparently. I've heard that he even caught you dinner one time.
Listen, this fish was huge. I thought that McCain's was going to call us and sue us. This is how big this fish was. Like, we had to eat it quickly, right? But Frankie, you've got a bit of a request for Siya.
Look, it's a natural fit, and I want to pitch this idea to him quickly, right? So you've got the Frankie's underwear range, all right? And obviously you are the model for it.
Used to be.
But I was
looking for a new guy. Now.
Well, this is what I'm thinking. I'm thinking, because it's one thing having like a really well-built man, advertising.
Because that's unrealistic expectation on normal men, right?
You need an average guy.
Yeah.
You need the average man.
Yeah.
And I'm willing to step into that role.
I am. You know, this is the best news I've heard today.
Is it?
Yeah, because Frankie's for everybody.
You see,
it's for everybody.
And also, his name is Frankie.
And my name is Frankie. Makes, like it's a fit.
I'm
keen.
I'm in.
Okay, really? Cool. I just have to run this past my fiance. I'm
like, oh, I thought you had that sorted already.
Just got a blast.
What's the concern there, Frankie? That people will see you in the underwear and now everyone obviously will
I'll
want
have to
you?
I'll have to strip down. You know, I'll just have to check with her how she feels about
sharing. You don't have to. You don't have to.
Don't have to.
You can have a shirt on and just, you know. There's ways of doing
that. Okay. Are you ready to be a sex symbol? Because now you're going to be objectified.
Oh, wow. Coming through, Mark Wahlberg.
You're going to be on the walls
of careful,
women.
Eh? Just ask for permission first before you answer that question.
Is it? I think we can all agree unanimously that the word sex symbol is never going to apply. I think we can be honest about it.
See, I'm pretty sure you're aware of these spirit groups, right? I mean, you've got the gwijo squad that comes through and follows you everywhere. You in PE, they're there. You in Cape Town, they're there. You in Joburg, they're there. Yeah. And I love the fact that I'm seeing it in the high schools as well coming up. I mean, you know, St. John's have got a video. St. Stithians have got one. Parktown Boys have got one. So we've gathered a few of these videos that have gone viral, even being posted by international hip-hop stars, right? We want to play them for you, and you have to tell us, you have to rate them.
Okay, cool.
Are you ready to rate them?
100%.
Is this Hilton?
Yes.
What are they saying? Hilton Corner?
Hilton College.
Hilton College.
That's cool. That's very cool.
All right. What's the captain's feedback on that?
I think I'll give it a 7 out of 10.
Strong 7. All right. Good.
Okay. Hilton gets 7. Wait, I just need to write this down. Hilton, 7 out of 10.
Aren't Hilton like a big rival of Grey?
No. I've played against him. They're not the big guy.
Okay.
No. They're all right. They're all right. Okay, next. All right,
next up, St. Stithians.
I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Now, I must tell you, Siya, if you go to St. Stithians and you do things, great things, you have a tree named after you. Kagiso Rabada's got a tree named after him there at St. Stithians. Does Grey have a tree named after you?
No.
Probably a whole rugby field named after you.
I'm actually going to send them a message now.
Yeah, you must.
No, but there's a trophy named after me.
See?
Yeah, there's a trophy.
Do you believe him?
I believe that Sia's got a trophy.
Yeah, there's a trophy.
Anneli claimed the other day she has a trophy at a primary school in Centurion.
Named after me.
A netball trophy, apparently.
He won't believe me. Mm-mm. And I actually do have it.
We need I need proof.
Yeah. You see? Doesn't believe you either.
Wow. Captain, my captain. Okay, how much are you giving St. Stithians?
I'll give them 8.
8 out of 10. Yo, nicely done. Okay.
Next up, Parktown Boys.
Parktown Boys?
7.5.
7.5. So just a little bit more than Hilton, a little bit less than St. Stithians. And then finally we have?
Smaller school, Grey College.
Okay. finish saying yes, yeah?
No, I don't know, because it's not my school.
No, it is your school.
No, this is Grey College.
Oh, the one in Bloom?
Yeah.
And you are Grey?
Yes, I'll give them three. Because they're Grey College. Because you're rivalry.
3 out of 10 for Grey Bloom.
Wow.
So therefore, St. Stithian takes it according to the captain. That is terrible.
I'm going to be in trouble. Some of my teammates from Grey College.
So let's talk about, you know, when you are with the, you know, with the Springboks, do those war cries make the world of difference? Because we out there, you know, we're singing our hearts out. We're shouting your name. You should hear the things people are saying. We love you. God. Mm. And when the chips are down, that's when the crowd gets the loudest. Yeah. Like, talk to us about that. Should we continue to do that?
No, 110%, because it does motivate us, and it does give us that edge when we need it the most. And, you know, and actually afterwards, when you, after a win, and then you go stand there and sing with the people, and I do it quite a lot, especially at Newlands. There's a lot of guys that come, and some of them are my schoolmates, guys I've played against at school, and they come to every game. It's really amazing. And it's South African. That's the most important thing. Mm. Imagine if we can have that in Japan or wherever we're playing in the world, you know.
Yeah.
It makes a huge difference.
Did you hear that, bosses? Sia invited us to Japan.
Yep. He literally did.
I don't know if you guys heard it, but that was a personal invite. That was a, hey guys, I'm throwing a little party in Japan later on this year. Please, can you come around?
The 947 Breakfast Club. Let's go. Another big interview on the 947 Breakfast Club.
Captain, my captain, in studio chatting with us. I mean, we were discussing the rugby game that happened this past Saturday.
Mm.
When you injured, Nesia, and do you watch the game, or does it give you heart palpitations to not be able to be on the field with the boys?
I do watch it, but it's like the worst thing to do, because it's really tough, because there's nothing you can do. And especially if your team is not doing well, it sucks to see. When they're winning, I'm fine.
So it's easier to watch them win, because you know when they win without you, it means they don't need you.
No, but it makes me happier when they win. Yeah,
it's so just rather tough. They win
without
you than lose without
you.
And you're obviously the captain, so you're watching the game and you're thinking, if I was there, I could inspire them right now. I could say this. Is that what you're thinking?
Oh, you think that. You don't always get it right.
No, sure.
You know, but you'd say, like, you'd look and see what you could have done differently. Mm. You know? Yeah.
And when it comes to halftime, let's say you are at the stadium, are you allowed to go into the change room to talk to them when you're not playing that day?
Yeah, but I'm not that guy, you know. I don't like that. I mean, you gotta give whoever is in charge at the time, you gotta give them the space. Like, I wouldn't want someone sitting and just come and tell me,
like,
you know.
The original supervisor.
If someone comes to me on the side and just taps me and tells me, listen here, this is what I see, then I don't mind that. Okay. It's always good to get advice.
Mm. All right, so speaking of sports, I mean, rugby is not the only thing you're interested in.
Yeah.
You're out here, you're fishing. What other sports, you know, tickles your fancy besides rugby?
I watch quite a lot of sports, like Formula One, athletics. Mm. I've got a lot of friends that do athletics. So anything that's on, I'll watch.
Mm.
Yeah.
Alex, can we have some dramatic music here? Some like dun 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 dun
dun dun. About this? You want this? More suspense. All right, no wait, I got it. Wait, hold on, wait. How about?
That's the one. We are gonna play the rapid sports game with Siya Kolisi. Everybody say aye. What happens is I'll give you a sport, and you have to give me the greatest person to ever play that sport in that district, discipline. There we go.
Yeah. Well, your favorite.
Your favorite, actually. Not even the greatest. This is not an official thing. Sia's not writing the new Guinness Book of Records. He's just giving his opinion. Are you ready?
Yes.
Football.
Benny McCarthy. I'm going for South African.
That's fine. Tennis. You have to say Amanda Kutsa now. Or Wayne Ferreira.
Kevin Anderson.
Oh.
You see?
Okay. Yeah. Cricket.
I've got too many.
Name one.
That's tough. I can't do that.
Jacques Carlos, Lance Klusner, Kepler Vessels.
Okay, I'll go for an old grey boy, Graham Pollock.
We'll take it. Basketball.
LeBron James.
Okay, athletics.
Casta, Wade, Akani. It's too many.
Luvo,
all of them, yeah.
Formula One.
Lewis!
Boxing.
Baby Jack and Diganto Bell.
Okay. Curling. Who wrote curling, guys?
Curling. The greatest sport on earth, guys. It's the greatest sport on earth.
No one knows anyone from curling.
What is your? Have you got a favorite team? Maybe of the curling federation? Is there?
No.
Have you ever watched curling?
No. This is getting tough. Yeah.
Rugby.
My favorite team is the Springboks.
That's a cheat. That's a cheat. That is,
it's cheat and it's safe. Okay, let's talk about Japan now. How are you feeling? Are you guys? Do you guys? Obviously, there's a proper. Let's get ready for it in a training camp. But you guys, when you're hanging out, how are you feeling about it?
Oh, we've had two camps now, but it's only the guys in your union. Like the Stormers will have a camp together. The guys are in the mix, so we're pretty excited. But obviously, for me right now, it's just about getting better.
Getting fit. Yeah.
Yeah. So hopefully, I get the opportunity to play. Hopefully in the championship. So okay. I just want to get better.
How's the injury going? Do you know?
No, I don't know. So I have to go and see the doctor, and then he must check.
He'll check for you.
Yeah. If it's healing nicely or not.
Okay.
But
well, we're holding
thumbs. 6 weeks. Yeah, six weeks.
So listen, currently there's a little cricket game playing just across the pond there in England. The Proteas are there, right?
Yeah.
And we recorded an advert for them.
Yes.
Okay, because we were like wanting them to know that we love them and we support them. We're going to play this ad, and then after we play the ad, you let us know if you'd like us to do one for the Springboks, because we're ready.
Okay.
You know, we are ready.
Uh-huh.
15 men have traveled to the land of the imperialists with only one goal.
To bring back the diamonds?
No, even bigger than that.
To meet Prince Harry?
No.
You're going to join the celebrations, aren't you?
In search of the silver and gold Cricket World Cup trophy.
Just wishing you a very good luck.
It's South Africa represent. We are the best.
Woohoo! The DR Fire boys, bring it home.
I don't like cricket. I love it.
I don't like cricket.
There's only one kind of fire burning in our hearts.
Protea fire!
Protea fire!
Go Proteas!
Protea fire!
Good luck, boys. Remember, you've got the whole crazy South Africa behind you.
Boys, we're backing you all the way.
Fireball.
You guys are gonna bring home the World Cup. Yay! Woohoo!
The whole South Africa is backing you guys.
Yes, I'll have my Amla beard ready tomorrow and my Imran Tahir passion. Go Proteas!
Oh, captain, my captain.
In Faf, we trust.
Ooh, Fafi, who, Fafi, who, Fafi, who. Proteas we are, Proteas will be. Proteas forever, ever and me.
Hey, Faf and the guys, we just want to wish you all the best of luck. Do your best. We love you and are praying for you.
And Faf, we believe you will lead the team to victory.
One of the greatest games on planet Earth.
KG, I just want to see ducks, royal ducks. Quack, 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 quack. We are winning this one. Go, boys, Protea fire!
For some, it's all about the cricket.
Shamsi, don't forget to call us when you get a wicket.
Hashtag Protea fire!
Umlila, 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 yachis, umlila, umlila.
For others, there's more.
Oh, well, from my side, there's a lot to look at. Those buns, yummy.
Go, Proteas!
Every ball.
It's beautifully caught!
Every six.
Amla, we need a few sixes, sevens if possible.
We'll be there.
Right, Siya? What do you think? What do you think?
You guys are getting me pumped. I'm ready to play now. That is amazing. We would definitely love to hear that.
Oh, so it's a go-ahead.
A go-ahead.
We've got it's a go-ahead. Amazing.
No, hang on.
Whose voice is that, though?
Are you
it is.
Are you
so cool.
It's Frankie.
One man. Siya Kolisi.
So cool.
Come on.
No, but hang on. This is what
please,
I'm saying.
Please say from the dusty streets of Zwide.
Hold on. Okay. Siya, are you sure? Because we've sent this to the Protea squad. It's not going so well over there. Are you sure you want the Springbok one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just say from the dusty streets of Zwide.
From the dusty street. Oh, sorry.
No.
Stage right.
Yeah.
from the dusty streets of Zwide.
That's really cool.
All right, so we've got the go-ahead.
Yeah.
All right, when you guys are on the way to Japan, we'll get together. And those voice notes are from the people in Johannesburg. That's they sent really those cool. in. So we'll get them to send in for you guys, and then we'll send it to you, and you guys can play it there.
No, it's amazing.
That's all right, really cool. On the way, Siya Kolisi and Tembekile team up for Classic or Not. Stay tuned for that.
How's it, guys? Warwick here. What the chances that I could give a shout-out to Siya Kolisi? He knows me. I think I'm one of the biggest Western Province supporters up in Joburg. Siya, my brother. Let it go well, my brother. Recover soon. We need you at the World Cup. We're going to need you. And let's get back stronger and better, my brother. Go well, Siya.
The 947 Breakfast Club. The 947 Breakfast Club.
Bring it back.
Classic or not, it's old.
But is it a classic?
You decide.
Classic or not.
All right, so today in Classic or Not, we're going to spice things up a little bit because Siya Kolisi is in studio. So yes. Him and Tembekile are going to team up on this classic. But I must add that one of the people who vote in Classic or Not are going to get these groovy Freedom of Movement shoes that Siya has brought into studio because he's teamed up with them. They're raising money to build a rugby pitch. So you can go to the website freedomofmovement.co.za. All the information is there. The shoes are amazing. We love them. We're wearing them. It's for a good cause as well.
Or if you're in Joburg, obviously, and you got a little space between 10 and 11.
Rosebank Mall.
Rosebank Mall. Freedom of Movement. Sia's going to be there.
He'll be signing things, taking photos, checking out shoes. So head on over there. Right now, Classic or Not, Tembekile and Sia, come towards us.
Okay, so before we get to it, can I just say I was expecting there to be blood on the floor. excuse me. A queen from Bloemfontein and a rugby player picking a song together.
Okay.
This is the second Kadesa, guys. But anyway, here we are. This is it. We are the world. We are the people. 1983 was the year when this came out. This particular song was written by Melvin Matthews. I don't imagine that means anything to you guys. It was the B-side of Life is Going On. You Must Have It Now.
Lionel Richie?
No.
Anita Baker?
It's local.
Life is Going... Sipa Hot Sticks, Bubble Say?
No. Madonna of the Township?
Brenda Fassi. Life is going on.
You do. Who else? Which else? What other song? What was her biggest song in the
Weekend
80s?
Special.
Yes.
Is that the one you're going for? Sia, that's the classic. What does the song mean to you?
No, I love it. I actually loved this song since I was young, but then I watched Fill Up Ellis Park.
Yeah.
And I've never seen anything like that before. People were sitting on the roof.
Yeah.
And to see her perform. Obviously, that time there was no social media. The only way you could see the person was to go see them live. And for me to see her, she's been doing this. All these people that are trying to do nowadays, she's been having it. She really inspired. I love her music, all her music. So that was really special.
Back to the hits.
Back to the hits.
Monday to Friday.
With Anele,
Frankie,
Tembekile,
Cindy, and Alex.
947. The 947 Breakfast Club.
The 947 Breakfast Club.
You know what she was talking about.
And also, and you know she dabbled because she lived.
Wow.
We think it's a classic. I think it's a classic. Frankie?
There's no denial. I don't think anyone's going to say it's not a classic. Come on.
Cindy? Alex?
Yeah, absolutely, guys.
Joburg?
Weekend Special, for sure a classic.
I go weekend special. It's a damn classic. Here come the boca. Here come the boca.
Hey, he's a classic.
Yes, this is a real classic, guys. I'm with you guys.
Captain, my captain, this is a classic, Buddha.
Buddha!
Song for her too. This is a classic.
Sia, your music taste is like your rugby playing. Excellent. Definitely a classic.
To my captain,
is that really?
I see you're gonna win the World Cup for us, your onion.
Like your queen from Bloemfontein. Base to be blooming with a like a good old classic, your good things. Onion!
Kaka! Tembekile is a classic! Woo! So see me! Woo! Hear me in the week! Yes!
Makwana, good morning! You just voted for classic or not? Thank you. It is a classic indeed. Well done.
It's a classic, yes.
And you know what? What size shoe are you?
What, pardon?
What size shoe are you?
I can't hear you, Anele.
What size shoe are you? What
size
by Anele
Nyawen? Size 3 and 4.
Size 3 and 4?
Size 3, yes. Size, no, size 3.
You decide.
It's like a multiple choice.
Size 4 when she shops alone.
Okay, my company. Final choice. I'm size 3, Anele.
Okay, size 3. Listen, we're going to get you some of the shoes from Freedom of Movement, okay?
Well done,
Sissi. Oh, thank you so much.
They're really nice. Go look on our social media pages. We're all wearing them. They're really nice. You're getting them from Siya Kolisi. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Miss size 3 or 4. Size 3 when she's with her boyfriend. Size 4 in real life. I know these
problems.
I know these problems. I'm size 9 by myself. I'm size 8 when I'm with people. All right. Siya, thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you, Siya.
Thank you for having me, guys.
It's been a power hour. Catch him at Rosebank at 10 o'clock. Freedom of Movement. And congratulations with all that you're doing. And we hope that we know you'll be successful in building that rugby field for less fortunate kids.
I appreciate it.
All right. Siya Kolisi's out.
That's it from the 947 Breakfast Club. Do it all over again. We'll do it again tomorrow. 6 to 9 a.m.